So believe it or not, I tend to receive a lot of questions about this right here, blue painter's tape. If you want to hear more, stay tuned to the video. Regie here, your friendly neighborhood bodybuilder and comic book collector, and I want to welcome you to another one of my videos. In this video, we are going to spend some time talking about this, blue painter's tape. And part of the reason why I'm making this video is because I get the question about blue painter's tape fairly often from people, and I've received it over a long period of time. And so I am finally deciding to go ahead and to create a video. And it's easier for me to do the video, to record it, to put my thoughts into that, and then to point people in the future to this video to help them to understand why I use blue painter's tape. It allows me to be much more consistent and much more thorough in my response versus trying to type it all out in a comment when I get it. This is much, much easier. So if you've ever wondered why I do it, I am going to explain it in this video. If you've never wondered why, I apologize that you have to watch this video. At least I hope that you watch this video. But I want to explain it. I want to break it down. The long and short of it is personal preference. There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It is personal preference. I choose to use blue painter's tape because I like it. I think that blue painter's tape is a versatile tape, and it allows me to do a lot with just a single roll or a stack of rolls versus having multiple kinds of tape that I'm always trying to find, I'm always trying to refill. I am also a creature of habit, and so I like having one thing consistently that I can use instead of different things. And so it's just part of it is personal preference, it's comfort, it's all of that kind of stuff. There is no wrong way to use tape. There is no wrong tape. There is no right tape. This is just nothing more than personal preference. And my wife knows me. She actually picked this thing up from Home Depot. It's a pack of nine of the 3M Scotch blue painter's tape. And there are four rolls here. This is the fifth roll, and I've kind of whittled down the supply. But again, it's because I use it in so many different ways. And so I want to talk a little bit about how I use it and why I use it. But remember, it's all personal preference. There are other types of tapes out there that will do exactly what I'm describing here. But I want to kind of explain how I use it and why I use it. And then you can decide what you want to do, whether you want to go out and get blue painter's tape or whether you want to just keep doing what you've always done because it works. So whenever I go to a comic shop on New Comic Book Day, for example, I always get a bag and board from the comic shop and part of the reason why I do that is because I don't like to transport my books without them being in bags and boards. And to be honest with you, I never remember to bring bags and boards to the comic shop. So I always just get their bags and boards. And most comic shops in my area do not actually use the resealable bags for their poly bags. And I do like the resealable bags, but they tend to just use the basic bag and board. And so because of that, I have to seal the comic when I bring it home, and the blue painter's tape works quite nicely for that. When I do buy a lot of older books, I tend to put a lot of those books into Mylar specifically, and this is just a regular poly bag, right, that I use the blue painter's tape on, but I buy a lot of older books and I like to put them in Mylar, and I think it's because it makes the book pop, and I think it makes the book look really nice. The thing about Mylar is that this is a harder material. It's a thicker material, and I actually prefer the 2 mil bags, but some people actually prefer the 4 mil. But regardless of which one you use, the blue painter's tape actually works quite nicely for being able to hold this back flap down. And if you happen to be using something like the 4 mil, which is much more rigid, this flap can also be kept down with some blue painter's tape. Can you do it with Scotch tape? Yes. You have to use two pieces of Scotch tape on either side? Probably. I honestly don't know. I prefer the blue painter's tape. The other thing that I will say is that with this particular tape, I don't have to worry about residue. It tends not to leave residue on either the poly bag or the Mylar bag, which I like. And then it also tends not to tear the bag or to ripple the bag. And again, there are lots of different kinds of white tape out there that you can buy that will do exactly what I'm describing. But again, I'm kind of articulating what it is that I like about blue painter's tape, not necessarily saying you can only use blue painter's tape. But it's a nice way, a very clean way to be able to secure either a Mylar or a poly bag without essentially damaging the bag. So just a couple of reasons why. When I bundle up books because I've sold them or I'm shipping them off, I will also use a blue painter's tape for that. Inside the Gemini shipper, when I actually sell or ship raw books, when you fold down the Gemini shipper, it doesn't actually stay collapsed. And so I like to use a strip of the blue painter's tape in the back behind the book to hold down the flap of the Gemini shipper to hold it in place. And again, so it's versatile and it's strong enough to actually hold down some cardboard that doesn't necessarily want to be held down. So I like it for that purpose. Whenever I am shipping slabs as part of like a giveaway or something like that, I always wrap my slabs in bubble wrap and I use a piece of blue painter's tape to secure the bubble wrap as I wrap it horizontally and then vertically, two pieces of tape in either direction to kind of hold things in place. And another thing that I like about the blue painter's tape is I tend to fold the edge of the painter's tape to make it easier for people to peel it off. I will oftentimes write notes on there like pull here, or if I'm doing something kind of intricate where you need to pull certain pieces of tape first before others, I will have the little, you know, I will fold over the edge, write a little note like one on those that need to be pulled first and then two on those or whatever. But again, it's just, I like blue painter's tape, so I find ways to use it and I like to have fun with it, if you will. And again, it's all about personal preference. To be honest with you, I think that's about it. I think that might be all that I can tell you about this type of tape. And again, it's personal preference. If you have something that works for you, do that. I hope that you enjoy watching this video. I hope that I was able to answer questions. If you indeed had questions about the blue painter's tape, I hope that I've addressed them here. Certainly, you can leave questions, comments, and thoughts in the comment section, and we can mix it up there. If you need to reach out to me, feel free to do so at RegieCollects on Instagram or RegieCollects@gmail.com. Oh, before you go, if you are interested in adding a cool book to your collection, you definitely want to listen up. This week's Go Collect giveaway is this book right here. It is X-Men number 127. This is a 9.8 white pages, a Chris Claremont story, John Byrne cover and art, and it is also a Proteus appearance. Love some Proteus. So this is the Go Collect book that I am giving away. In just a moment, I'm going to give you the phrase that you need. But what you'll need to do is you'll need to head over to the community tab where you will find a post that I've put up where I talk about this particular book. You click that link and it's probably going to be a blue link. You click it, you go to MailChimp, you type in three pieces of information. Two of them are relevant to you. The third one is the phrase that I'm going to give you in a moment. You plug all that in, you hit the submit button, and then you are in the running to actually add this book to your collection. Next, you tune in to the Ready, Set, Go preview show, which airs on Sunday night at 7:30 p.m. Pacific time to find out if you are the winner. All that we ask is that you be a resident of the United States, a resident of Canada, or have a mailing address in the U.S. And then I also want you to be a subscriber of the channel as well. And I will also mention to you that Go Collect is still doing their 30-day free access. All you have to do is use the promotional code that is in the description of this video, and you get 30 days of free access to Go Collect. The phrase that you need to plug in is blue. B-L-U-E is the phrase that you need. Good luck.